सो गो सीडी, हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू आर अवेयर ऑफ गो कंटिन्यूस डिलीवरी, द प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर इट्स एंड जेनकिंस? या मोर पीपल, थैंक गॉड. सो गो सीडी इज जस्ट लाइक जेनकिंस बट लिटिल बिट मोर. एंड आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट सम ऑफ द बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस. सम ऑफ देम विल अप्लाई टू जेनकिंस ऑल्सो, बट मोस्ट ऑफ देम आर फॉर गो सीडी. या एंड माई फ्रेंड अली डिड अ वर्कशॉप हियर लाइक 2 डेज बैक. सो या अनदर थिंग आई फॉरगॉट इज आई एम अक्षय मनकर फ्रॉम थॉटवर्क्स. आई होप यू. सो या यूज स्क्रिप्ट. सो यूजिंग वॉट आई मीन बाई यूजिंग स्क्रिप्ट इज बेसिकली यू नीड यू शुड नॉट राइट ऑल द कमांड्स इन योर बिल्ड टूल, इन योर सी आई टूल, राइट? इन जेनकिंस, राइट? अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल हैव सीन लाइक दे राइट 5, 7, 8 और इवन मोर कमांड्स. Because when you use script, right, you can reuse the code, like you can reuse those scripts, you can test them, you can write tests for them, and then track the changes also. So if somebody breaks it, you can just git blame and beat that guy probably. And try Rake for this. We tried Rake for this in our project, and it has been really great for us. Like, you just run Rake tasks. And another thing, if you are using bash scripts, you need to have that set minus e and set minus x. Set minus e will basically break the script whenever some error happens, and set minus x will print everything, all the commands. So config.xml. So this is so you need to back it up continuously because it is everything for Go CD. Well, almost. Go maintains a Git repository for itself in the Go server. You just need to add a post commit hook so that every time Go commits, so whenever you change something from UI, it makes a change into that config XML and commits it. You just need to have a post commit hook and push it somewhere that is safe. So artifacts are these things which your builds produce. Like when you run tests, when you compile your code, right? You just need to when you compile your code, and let's say you create a jar or you create a RPM or whatever. And it has been tested, right? So you need to keep it safe. They are very precious, but they are precious only till you need them. Like, they have been deployed to production, and then they have been rolled out of production for years. You don't need them. So Go has this option called never clean up artifacts for some pipelines, but it can be dangerous because the way Go cleans up space, so when Go maintains the history of artifacts, right, it says it has this option, like when disk space is less than X, start deleting till you have XGB free. So let's say you marked a lot of builds never clean up artifact, and there are a few builds which don't have this thing marked. You basically end up Go leaving no choice but deleting all artifacts of those builds. So sorry, even those artifacts whose like which were built like a second ago, and they just get deleted. So this is another reason why you should have a separate disk for varlib go artifacts. This is the location where artifacts are stored in on Go server. So if let's say so in var log, right? If you have a bad program which is creating a lot of logs, that might also end up telling Go to delete artifacts, and you don't want your recent artifacts to be deleted. So it's generally like I would suggest to use a separate disk or a partition. Another thing is templatize. So Go gives you a very good feature called templating. So your builds, right, they can be they can be made into a template, and those templates can be parameterized to create pipelines. So yeah, when you see your prod deployment and staging deployment, they differ by only a few parameters, like a chef environment name or a few IP addresses, or it can be like where to pick the artifact from, what artifact to deploy, right? So you can just create a template and have these things as parameters. When you create the pipeline, you give those parameters, and you have you have one build. So another thing is the similar thing applies for building multiple projects. So you have like 5 repositories, all of them build, let's say, Scala code. You you need to do Scala compile and Scala test and Scala SBT, sorry, SBT make RPM, and it all does the all of them would do the same thing. So why not have a same template and just different repositories? So basically you're saying no to duplication, and when you want change something, give me 1 second, 1 minute. When you want to change something, you thank yourself.
No.
One day. Yeah. And fan in, so parallelize everything. Give me just one minute. I'm really sorry. So fan in is very brilliant feature that if you have a source code and you have two builds and then accept and test, then you want to package it. So basically, this package will wait until both of them have been finished. So basically, you are running multiple tests parallelly on different agents. So you are getting lesser build time. Or jobs are also an alternative, but jobs, so all these jobs will wait for the next job to run. So the parallelization can happen at only one level here. But these are also good things. And when you get lesser build time, you have more team happiness. And more team happy, they would praise you like gods. So no retrigger policy, this is the last thing, promise. So retriggers happen when like cucumber tests, they have put some weight and all, and it fails. I've seen a lot of people just retrigger the build 3 times, 4 times, maybe it passes sometimes. And this is very bad because some smart guy once said, once a window in a building is broken and left unrepaired, the building starts to go downhill rapidly. So if you have these unmaintained things and people have this habit of retriggering, right? This thing grows. And as I promised, this was last. Thank you.